说嘛，说朝鲜的关系嘛，哈，是吧？是吧？是不是？是不是？是不是说？
Some of you have to move out today, huh? When I came down from the lobby, I saw many sitting there at breakfast table. I thought it's breakfast time. So I joined them. I thought you have just to get in at 8 o'clock.
Understand English?
I wish I could speak all the languages in the world so that I can communicate with you. In your own mother tongue, then you probably will feel even better, huh? But I'm not that clever. I should have. Huh? I should have studied all this time. Well, it might not be so late. I might try again. What do you think? You think I still can try? Late career comer. So how did you manage to sleep? You have time to sleep? I mean, you do anyhow, you know. During meditation session, no? Wow. I believe you. I absolutely believe you. I agree. Okay, if you have any question, you can come up here and ask me. The people who have never seen me before, can you raise your hand? This is the first time, raise your hand. Okay, is this stage safe for them to come up? Is it safe?
Yes.
Was for so many hundreds of people? Okay. And maybe you come here and have a look at me. Bring your, or that you cannot bring the translator, right? Just come here. The people who never saw me before, and the rest just, I can't come on? I'm not sure. Oh my God, do you know how much you wait in karma? Okay, just stay there for a while and come back later, okay? Okay, enough for a while, enough for now. Enough for now. So have a good look here. It's the person in the photo that you always wanted to see. Is there any difference? Huh? More beautiful than photo? You make me believe it. I like to believe that. So you feel good? You don't regret your initiation, your sacrifice of a few fishes? Any question? Newcomer? Any question you want to ask? Yeah. Good question, huh? Don't make nonsense here. We don't have time. You happy? You see me?
Yes, I forgot
that
it was you.
Or okay. If you're so happy, that means it's me. Or does it matter whether it's me or not? Understand?
Yeah.
If you see someone look like me, at least in a dream, and it makes you happy, then it doesn't matter.
Somehow it doesn't look exactly like you, but I know it matters. I just come and hug you.
Okay. You don't need to ask, is the master or not the master. Huh? If you're happy, it's fine. It means the blessing, you know. Huh? Okay? Yeah. Because in a dream, sometimes you forget to recite the five names, right?
And I just feel so happy, I just come and hug you and cry to you.
I tell you, speak in the microphone. Right.
Okay. You hug me enough already, right? Good. Fine.
No, not even.
Because in a dream or during the unconscious or samadhi stage, sometimes you forget to recite the five names to verify whether the vision is real or not. Don't matter. It's okay. If you wake up, you're happy. That means it's real. And even if it's not, okay, practice again. That's fine, that's fine. That's the purpose of the dream. Okay? That's the purpose. You should have more happy dreams like this. No problem. No need to remember where the master really wants. If you can remember to ask, it's fine. If you cannot remember and you're happy, that means it's good for you. That means it's true. Huh? Whatever happened to us, if it makes us happy in a dream, well, it's a dream anyhow. So what's the big deal? Okay, next one.
师父，首先谢谢你照顾这个因果的幼稚。我想请问一个问题，就是说，越聪明的人越没有智慧。那么我想请教一下，我没有这样讲，请教一下。误会了，我说学问太多了，太那个迈向那个知识的成分了，要习自己的脑太多，书水太多。 有太多那个，不是每一个有学问的多就比较没智慧，不是这样子。如果我们都是相信那个书啊，你懂不懂？相信学校的那种，太偏向那个地方，而不是用自己，不是自己真正的找自己那个原本的智慧的话，是我们就比较偏向一面，然后这样比较没有真正的智慧，只有那个书学的学问。 只有世界的那个什么聪明这样子而已，世界的不是聪明，是 knowledge 怎么样？知识对这样子啊，你误会了，不要乱讲，聪明的人怎么没智慧？对不起，学问高并非聪明，知道啊？那我们谁有说我们自己可以念呢？可以，意思说有那种记忆力很好，这样并非聪明呢？智慧还是不一样的。
那在这个人生大梦里面，我觉得要战胜头脑是真的一件很困难的事情。除了多打坐以外，可是有时候打坐得到的，有时候我又担心是头脑做出来的东西，而不是真正智慧在成长。请师父告诉我们，就是说要怎么样最好的方法，怎么样去战胜这个头脑，做自己的主人。
不管他嘛，他做他的，你做你的。
他习惯了，我们打坐他胡思乱想是吗？久以后会习惯了啊，不简单，我们才要做，简单，因为做干什么？简单做太便宜，啊，太简单了是不是？因为不简单的，我们才试看看嘛，啊，那智慧也能时时都开呀。 就是你没有注意在那边的，比方说你家有一个窗户，唯一的窗户，可以看出去，啊，你没有注意往那边看了，你就往另外一个墙壁看，当然看不到外面了。所以我叫你注意在那窗户那里而已啊，哈，不管你有什么学问，你有多少那个世界的那种收集的材料啊，你不要管它嘛，你不要对那个骄傲。 你不要对那种世界的材料收集回来那种材料，觉得非常非常那个傲慢，那这样没有影响到你的修行，你智慧还是本来就有了，啊，不会影响。我意思说，如果一个人对他自己那种世界的那么小的一点点的收集的材料，很傲慢的话，他就比较很难找到智慧了。就这样，因为这就小部分而已嘛，是吧？多数的人对这个。 对自己的那个什么
certificate, 怎么讲? Certificate. 江书啊, 对对对, 他的成就啊, 追得非常骄慢, 所以才有问题, Okay, last one. Give me first, you already have the last one. Okay, Mexicana, Yes.
Maestra, queremos decirle que el pueblo de México la ama muchísimo. Somos pocos los que hemos empezado, pero tenemos la sinceridad en nuestro corazón. Todavía nos gana el ego y quisiéramos de paso pedirle su fuerza agregada para que nos ayude a vencer esta situación. Maestra, nuevamente le repetimos que el pueblo de México la quiere mucho, que son muchísimos los que la conocen. Somos un grupo pequeño que estamos iniciados, pero tenemos la sinceridad de nuestro corazón.
Mm-hmm. Master, we wanted to tell you from Mexico that many, many people in Mexico know of you and they love you very deeply. And although there's only a small group of Mexicans that are practicing together, they're very sincere and they want to do the most they can to spread your teachings in Mexico.
I know that. Yes, I appreciate that.
Queremos pedirle su ayuda, que sabemos de antemano que ya nos la ha dado, ¿verdad? Para, pues más que nada para aprender a controlar nuestro ego, que es muy grande, ¿verdad? Porque nos dejamos dominar muchas veces por emociones, pues no muy gratas.
Muchas gracias. That's all I know. You translate?
She wanted to ask for your help for all of the disciples within the group in Mexico, that you may help them with their ego so that they may serve you in the best way that they can.
Gracias por su ayuda a la humanidad.
Thank you for your help to humanity.
En general.
In general.
Quisiéramos ser portavoz de una invitación en un futuro no muy lejano para ver si tenemos la bendición de su presencia en nuestro país.
She would like to ask your blessing if sometime in the near future you may be able to come physically to Mexico and bless the people there.
Maybe.
Con nuestro corazón nos inclinamos ante su presencia y que Dios la conserve por muchísimos años.
From our deepest heart, we appreciate your presence in our lives.
Okay.
Gracias.
Boys?
Yes. I would like to know, has things happening in our life, events, good things, bad things, natural disasters, and all these things have a meaning?
Mm-hmm.
And is it a good thing to be aware of such hidden meanings and significance behind all these events?
Yes, I got you. Yes, yes. Well, they happen for our spiritual development, even though sometimes during this crisis, during this happening, we might not be able to understand. But everything has some purpose. Okay, if you can be aware of the hidden meaning of them, it's fine. If you cannot, just let it be. Things happen, doesn't matter how it happens. It's not what happens is important. It's how we react to that event is important. The event is there so that we can reflect ourselves, our development, you know. Then we know we have grown up until which height, yeah? For example, okay, say, what now? Okay, I just make an example so it's quicker for you to understand. Now, there are recently many journalists in newspaper in different parts, like in Taiwan or in some places we have often gathered a lot, and they write many things that is not true about us. And some people get upset and tell me and cry and all that, thinking that because of them, I get my name blackened, and they're upset for me, they cry and all that. I say, there's no need. Understand? They write what they write. I am what I am. And then what I react to them is important, not what they write to about me is important. If they write something good about me, whether I am proud, I'm so excited, happy, and feeling so, you know, so arrogant, that is bad for me. You understand? Not what they write good about me is good, but what I, my attitude to it, is good or bad, for myself alone. So, and then if they write bad thing about me, whether I really am upset, I feel bad, so long time, I hate them, I want to make revenge or not. If I do that, it's no good for me. Means I am not truly so developed to have my peace in every moment, in every situation. Now you understand? So, if you look into this situation like this, how you feel, how you react, and how you solve the problem, that is the lesson. I mean, that is the tool, you know, to help us to remember who we are, how great we are, how tolerant, how loving, how understanding. I also feel upset sometimes, for a while, very short, because of the situation, that it should not happen that way. It should happen in a more beautiful way. Just my expectation like that. But I'm not upset because of these bad people, or they write bad thing about me, or expect they write good thing about me. They write bad thing because they don't know me. Even you don't know me. How outside people know me? This is a very obvious reason. They don't know me. And I'm not going to go out into the world and tell all the journalists how good I am. Even if I tell them, whether they believe me or not, that's another question, see? Why should they believe me? Even you, the so-called disciples, you came here by yourself voluntarily, and you really love God so much that you can even humble yourself to ask questions and learn from me. Sometimes you doubt me. You think bad thing about me. You look at my appearance and my action in a distorted way, and then criticize me and leave the path. Yeah, you look at my personality instead of my teaching. I'm born the way I am. God made me the way I am. I can't. I can't, you know, wink-wink myself, jig-jack myself to please everybody the way you think. I am what I am, and I'm perfect, finished. You are perfect, finished. If you don't know you are perfect, then you have to know. You have to learn how to accept yourself as perfect. And anything not perfect, according to your opinion, you change if you want. I think I am perfect. I don't mean sometimes I don't make mistakes according to your opinion, but that's all right. I accept my mistake too, as long as I don't stick there all the time and thinking it's good. But maybe it's good. Maybe my mistakes is necessary for somebody else. It looks like a mistake, but it might not be. Might not be a mistake. For example, there's a man who crying in distress or emotional. Maybe he looks handsome, he good looking, and I might hug him, comfort him. In your opinion, in your eyes, maybe I should not do that. Maybe I should refrain from hugging him because I'm a woman and he's such a good looking and young guy. But I care not about what you think. Understand? Yes. So maybe in that instant you think I make a mistake. But maybe my mistake was necessary for that man. Yeah, he needs it. He needs my mistake. Maybe I shouldn't do it to keep my reputation more flawless, to keep your respect. But I don't care. Why should I care for everybody's opinion? His opinion might not be always correct. I just do what I feel correct at that moment, according to my understanding. And I always stand for what I believe and what I feel at that moment only. Anything else, I'm not responsible. So that's the way it is. So you see, so that's one thing. So if all the newspaper or people outside talk bad about me and I feel very hateful toward them, you know, then it's it means I don't understand. That means I still have to practice harder. I still have to control myself and try to look into the situation better, huh? With more intelligence. Oh, so that is my job. Their job is to write what they want. They are responsible for their actions. I have to be responsible for my own actions. See? So I look at it this way. They don't know me. They cannot understand me. It's fine. They write according to their belief, their understanding, their opinion, and that's all right with me. If I can, I explain to them. If I cannot, then I just forget it. Yeah? And a second, sometimes they understand me. They know me. They know I am good and not the way they write. But they had to write it because their situation forced them to write it. Maybe their editor, their newspaper, or they need the money. Yeah? They need to be famous. Maybe they are in probation of that newspaper. If they don't write anything so exciting, so extraordinary, so outrageous, then they cannot get the job. They cannot go ahead. Things like that. And in that case, even if they already know me and still write bad things about me, because of their situation, or they earn money, or they earn their fame, or they earn their job, let it be. I'm happy to help him. Yes, I can help everybody in different ways. I don't need to help him in such a glorious way, like I give money to him, or and then he has to thank me. Whatever it is, it takes me to help him. That is fine with me. You understand? So either way, it's fine. Everything is fine. I have to tell you that even though we are spiritual practitioners, we don't always have the understanding immediately about every situation that we encounter in our life. Did you bring your earphone with you? Yes? Yes, yes, so you can hear. Oh, fine, then you'll find where you are. You see, you don't always understand. But at least, because we practice, after a few minutes of anger and immediate reaction, we reflect. You say, what is this here? You can sit on top, honey. Sit on here. Because it's so short. Sit on the stage. Okay. Be comfortable. You know, don't blame yourself if in some moment of natural reaction you feel angry, huh? Or you feel you want revenge. But afterward, after it subsides, you think, this is not the way I should react to this situation. I should react what? What should I do in this situation for the most beneficial way for myself and for the opponent? And that is the way it is. Not that you don't get angry sometimes, but you don't overgo, you don't overdo it, and you don't let the anger override you for a long time, which is affect your health, your spirit, and your situation. You see? Not that you don't get angry sometimes. We do. And it's good to be angry sometimes. You know, it's healthy. But what to do with the anger, that's another thing. Don't let it destroy you. Thing like that, for example, you see. So any event happen in our lives, this is for us to measure how we grow already, how growth in spiritual development. If you can look at it that way, it's fine. And try to know how to react to it for the best way for yourself. Okay, huh? Brother? Good question.
Yeah,
this
one. Yes.
Okay. 他跟我们一模一样平等，所以他知道跟我们一样。人家喜欢看师父，如果他因为他智慧已经知道了，两岁半他更知道。喜欢看。比我们还要知道。我们终生出来到两三岁了，还记得自己的过去、未来，多数的小孩都会记得，多数会知道来这边干什么，多数会知道好坏的事情，多数。超过一半。 然后我们越长大越忘记上帝了，越忘记自己的那个智慧，所以重新再来。嗯，就是两岁半多小啊，他知道很多事情你都不知道的。OK， 好了，别的。我们婴儿的时候是最快乐的呢，嗯、啊，除了饿的时候、痛的时候才哭，我平常都很快乐，为什么呢？因为我们知道，那个时候我们知道，还跟上帝同一体，还跟上帝沟通的。讲到四岁了以后，到三岁、四岁就开始慢慢退了，过去、未来都很迷糊。All of you understand? Yeah, good. You should bring your earphone or share it with a neighbor. If you have two, share one. Yes.
Master, first of all, thank you very much for initiating me. Before initiation, I had a lot of problems in my family and outside. Things are getting much better now. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. No question?
I got a question.
Ask your question. No need to praise or compliment me. You are here for question.
Okay. I want to know, I think you always teach us to help the world and help other people as spiritual practitioners. Currently, I have some problem with some guy at work. I think somehow he doesn't like me or something like that. So
why is that he doesn't like you? Do you know the reason?
I don't know the reason. I think it's because of some.
Since when?
Since like 3 years ago, when I started to work there. Seems like he looks at me, doesn't like. So I just want to know, for this situation, how can I help?
Okay.
And how can I develop a relationship?
Well, you have to see through him that he has problem of his own too. That he is also an individual with a lot of questions, a lot of complexity, a lot of unsolved mystery of his own life. Sympathize with him. Yeah? Compliment on him something that he is good at and begin to make friend with him. Be a good friend instead of waiting for him to be a good friend. Like him instead of waiting for him to like you. He has problem, okay? And of course, no, not everybody can like us all the time. Sometimes personality problem. Sometimes you have to check up yourself also why the person don't like you. Perhaps he's very fast and you are very slow, and you're deliberately slow. You try not to understand him and make him feel impatient. Yeah? So you try to cooperate with him. If you work with him, you have to find out what exactly that he doesn't like about you. Then you change that. I'll talk to him about it. Say, I'm really sorry that I will try, you know, I know my fault now, at which point, and I really want to try. Would you help me, teach me, you know, and be more patient, thing like that. Because somebody don't like us, it's not always his fault. Sometimes it's our fault too. Sometimes we just, you know, take it easy. Why hurry? You know, you work fast, it's your problem, man. I don't want to hurry. You see what I mean? Not that we are bad or anything, just personality. And when we work together, if we don't cooperate in the same pace, you know, same pace?
Yes, pace.
Pace, yes, not pace. So same pace, then it's difficult for both to feel relaxed and to feel, you know, at one together. So try to find out exactly what he doesn't like about you. And see if you can change or not. Whether you change it, it's good for you or not. Not that you have to change yourself all the time to suit everybody. It's not true. You have to see the situation whether it's truly your fault. And if what he doesn't like about you is true or not. If it's true, he's your teacher. You must learn. You must change. If it's true, if it's better for you to change, then change. If he's lousy, he expects too much from you, and his way is not good for you and not good for him and not really a good way, then forget him. But be friend with him. Okay? Try just to be friend and ignore the differences. We all have differences. Let him know that. Okay?
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Here.
Yes,
Hi, Master.
Hi.
At the moment, I'm in a very fortunate position in my life that I can offer all my time to serving your teaching and discerning humanity.
And I need to grow quicker so I can serve better.
But you're okay. Or you're not working? You're in a fortunate time of your life?
Yeah.
Go after initiation, is that what you mean?
I can devote all of my time to serving.
How's that?
Well, it's my situation in life now. That's what I'm doing at the moment, but I need to grow quicker, and that's why I wanted to become your disciple, your full-time disciple.
Oh, fine. You are full-time, all the time?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, what are you doing? For living, are you not satisfied with your work? You want to do something else?
There's no work more important than serving.
Huh?
There's no work more important than serving humanity or serving you.
No work more important?
Yeah.
What can you do? What do you want to do for the Almighty right now?
Just to give selflessly.
To give services? Well, that everyone do all the time. You see what you can do in your community. Yeah? The brother, sister needs you to do something, and you do it for them.
I'd like to have the opportunity to grow quicker,
Yeah, but you grow by that way. Don't push yourself. A baby just has to grow in his own time. You mean you won't follow me everywhere? Is that right?
Whatever is best. I would like to, of course.
What's best for you is best for me. But there is no need to leave home or do anything dramatic. No? What is your specialty? What can you do? You are what?
I was an engineer.
Of what?
Mechanical engineer.
Huh? Mechanical engineer.
Yeah.
You're a mechanic. And then?
And now I'm working in a center, one of your centers.
From where?
Building one of your centers.
Building center?
Building one of your centers.
Which one?
Brisbane.
Which one?
Brisbane.
Brisbane?
Brisbane, Australia.
Okay.
So I hope you come when it's
okay.
Finished.
It's good. And you are serving it already.
Yeah, but...
You are in service already.
When you were in Cambodia, I applied to move to Cambodia as a resident.
I see.
The timing was very crucial.
I know.
But
Cambodia.
Yeah.
Forget it.
Yeah.
I told you. Okay. It's difficult to make a village, spiritual village. I told you yesterday, because of the world. So just be where you are, do what you can. In those situations and in your power for your own development. At the moment, we don't have a center where I stay fixed. Even if there is a center, I don't stay there fixed. When I was supposed to be in Taiwan, I'm not always there all the time. See, because people also ask me to go here, go there. Maybe I go to Brisbane sometimes, I go to Mexico sometimes. But you have to really push me. I'm a very lazy person. I must confess. I must confess I'm very lazy. You know, if it's not because of you have been here already, and not because I have promised to come, I probably wouldn't come. It's very difficult for me to move out of my house or my anywhere. So every time I come, I feel great, like a great accomplishment. Like I'm very good, because I just can't do it otherwise. I love the people, I love you so much, but I can just love to be alone also. Either way, it's okay with me. And when I'm already alone, I don't want to change the situation. And when I'm with you, I don't want to go home. I'm just crazy like this. For example, if you stay here forever, every day like this, I would just accompany you every day. I'm just as happy. Yeah. Truly, it's me. I'm just funny. I don't know why. And if you just stick me in the house every day, alone, or with a few attendants, or with a few friends, sometimes come here, I'm also just as happy, and I would stay there forever too, if nothing else to do.
Yes, I just don't understand this, but this is the way I am. Yeah. So, you see, if I have a fixed place, I probably stay there forever, but it's not possible. Sometimes they drag me out, you know, go lecture or go retreat or thing like that, or some people cannot see me and I have to go see them. Otherwise, it's very easy for me just to have a center, huh? And then all of you come to see me. But never happened that everybody would come. There'll always be somebody, because of some reason, cannot come. And then also I have to go out anyhow. You know, is that not so? It's not everybody have money to buy ticket, come see me, yeah? Wherever I am. So sometimes I have to buy ticket, go see them. Sometimes their longing in their heart is so strong, I cannot resist, that's all. Otherwise, I'm very happy just to stay in any place, you know, and then welcome you. Stay with me forever, I don't care. But even if you stay with me close, you cannot always be with me, because I can't take all the my fans, you know, too many. I can't, it's an impossible task to take the whole group with me. There are so many people who work for me. Australia also, I mean, work in our group, huh? They are a staff group, huh? The residents. But they are not with me now. And sometimes they have to work, we work separately. We used to have Taiwan and we stay together, you know. Any foreigner or non-foreigner, anybody welcome. At that time, Taiwan still welcome foreigner. Now, you go there, they give you only 2 weeks visa. So even if I stay in Taiwan, it's inconvenient for you to come and stay, you know, long term. You see what I mean? Even if I stay in anywhere, always inconvenient for somebody. Suppose I stay in Australia, make a center out of Brisbane, fine, it looks good. All the Australian people happy. But, And how about the Chinese people? You know, the American people, and the Cambodian, the Thai people, they can't stay there. I mean, they can stay for a while, but not too long. And whenever they get a visa to Australia, maybe they have problem. Sometimes to go outside of the country, you must have some money guarantee in the bank. So the embassy will stamp the visa for you. They think you go to Australia, try to smuggle yourself in, get a job, and then don't leave there. I mean, go forever, stay there forever, and don't leave the country. So there's a lot of problem everywhere. If it were my world, my kingdom, then I just let you all of you come anywhere. I just stay in one place, all of you come. And if you even don't have money, we can send you money. Yeah? Then I don't have to go anywhere. We have a lot of disciples, everybody give him $1, he has a ticket in no time, right? No problem. It's not always a problem. But the problem is bureaucracy. It's a discrimination between the nations. It's a faith, lack of faith in God also. People believe that if too many, foreigners come to their country, they go bankrupt and things like that. Maybe it is true, but if they have faith in God, it's not so bad. And also you can't blame them, you know. Each country struggle to stand for survival, to organize their governmental system, and to protect their own citizens. If other people come and don't speak the language, don't understand the custom and try to make trouble, also they are scared, you see? And this is why we have visa problem. So wherever I stay, there will be always some problem for some of the group of the disciples. Never enough. So you just stay where you are. Do as much as you can. God knows your sincerity. It's not how much you do. It's the quality of your service. It's the sincerity that you offer. Huh? Okay, brother? Well, so many people who want to come and work for me, but I can't just take them. I wish I could. It sounds so good, you know. They have so devoted people to work for you and help you. I need to trim my English sometimes. I could have some English people hang around with me. But I don't know if we can fit, you know, after a while. Sometimes when we meet each other here, it's fine. But sometimes after we live with each other sometime, you know, then there's something else comes. Then you're homesick and you love sick and whatever, it comes along with it. And you went through a lot of tests and trials. and you suffer, and I suffer along with you. Some people come with me and then they get homesick. That I understand. I get homesick, fine. But then I don't want to go home. I must control myself. I must go through this test, and then I suffer every day. And then I feel it. And I feel it. Even without telling, I kick him out. And then everybody blames me. Master, so terrible. That person, so devoted. He forsake all the family, come to you, and then you just kick him out for no reason. You scold him. I leave too. I stand by my friend. He is innocent man, and you scold him like that, and you kick him out like that. Oh, no reason. I can't bear it. What kind of master is it? Let's go. Yes, yes. And then three or four stick together, go home. In negative thinking about me. You understand? Yes, everything affects me. And then I look like a bad mirror that reflect the bad images. And I got blamed for many things. Things are complicated. The minds are complicated. And if that person, if you are not homesick, suppose you're not homesick, you go with me, 100% devoted. But your family, we get lovesick. Ah, they miss you. And then they stay home and say, oh, Master, if you really are a good one, send my son home. And then what I do? Then I scold him. As I get out of my place, right now. And then maybe his friend or girlfriend stand by and say, what? He didn't do nothing wrong. This guy is so sweet. He comes to you with all devotion and sincerity, and you just kick him out like that? What shall I do? Do you understand this? So I never can win. Huh? I'm scared to take in a monastic disciple or follower or whatever, because everything I lose, every time. Or, if even you're not lovesick, somebody else lovesick with you. Yes. And it always happened that sometime in a residential area, you work together, male and female, cannot always avoid. That's natural. And then one of the female happened to like you because you're handsome. Huh? Young. Yeah. And then so she fell in love with you. Then she's also my disciple. Now you pray to stay with me as a monk. She prays to me so that to have you as a husband. Whom I listen to? Do you understand my situation? Either case, I cannot win. They happen all the time. Exactly when you want to devote it, your whole life, nothing but the whole life to me and to God, then things come. If you're just ordinary disciple, nobody bother about you. Even your best looking, somebody don't even see you. As soon as you follow me, you're next to me, you're shining. You're the one and only, you look good. You look better. You look desirable because Master wants you. And then you'll be in trouble. I really tell you, it happens. And it takes a lot of, you know, strong willpower for my part to keep you. Not your willpower alone. Because everything you do affects me. Eh? If somebody wants you, they pray to me, and I'm in trouble. Yeah, I'm in trouble all the time. About all this domestic problem. Yes, a husband wants to leave home, follow me. And the wife stay at home, lonely, pray to me. Sooner or later, we had quarrel, me and the husband. And then he has to pack. And then where else he go? Home. Where else he go? Huh? Home. And then they're happy together. Meanwhile, still criticize me. Oh, the master is not as I think, you know. She get mad. She kick me out. She's angry. She's unreasonable. God, I'm so disappointed, you know, in her. Yeah. Yes, yes, yes. Yes. Some people not only left me afterward, but had a bad illusion about my attitude. Negative thinking. Because the way I kick him home. I had to kick him, otherwise he don't go home. Because if I'm always sweet to him, yes. One couple, I had get along well with one, but the other one prayed that he goes home. So we just had quarrel, and I had to kick him out. And then still now, he still don't forgive me yet, because his ego hurt. I had to kick him, you know, really hurt him terribly, so that he can leave me. Otherwise, he would never leave me. He loves me so much. He likes to be around with me. That I understand. But how about a wife? She likes her husband more than she likes me. Fine, I understand that. But he has to go home, so one of us has to be the bad guy. It's me, always. How can he be the bad guy? You know, he's a disciple and already devoted and want to come to me. Nothing changed him. But both of them are my disciples. Each one pray for different purpose. Sometimes I cannot choose. It's very difficult to be a master, do you know that? Sometimes I cry too. Because I had to do things that I don't like to. For the sake of what? Yes. If the husband loves me more than his wife, if the wife loves me more than her husband, then she comes to me, he comes to me. But the husband wants her more than she wants master. I said, then come along, both of you. Then you have both have me and husband as well. No, I like family life better. Well, that's her choice. But that choice put me in trouble. You understand? That's the problem. So think twice, think 200 times before you follow me. I mean closely, be a resident for good. All this devotional talk and vows, watch out for me. Watch out. I love all of you. I would have loved to have built a big house, big village. All of you can come anytime. Be my guest, be your home. I love that more than anything. But it is not practical in this world. You have too many ties, too many karma. And the Maya force is very strong. Don't think the disciple next to you is a Buddha all the time. He's worked by Maya too, by the dark force too, to drag you down, to drag you out, to test you, to make you in trouble, make you struggle. And that caused trouble to me. He cannot trouble me directly, he troubles you, and then you trouble me. That is very convenient. So, please, stop having illusion about following the master. Be the disciple, the foremost, the runner-up or whatever. Just stay where you are and try to work as best as you can. I can make use of all of you. But where would we go? Where would we stay? Huh? What would we do with all your wives and husbands and kids and family and brothers, sisters and friends? Even brother, sister and friend make trouble. Some people follow me and then their relatives sell me because I get mad. You know, not just follow me like a resident, even just to come eat vegetarian and meditate and improve your quality even. I never taught you anything that is bad for you or your family, did I? Never. Everything is just good for you and for them. But they don't like it. They don't like that you love somebody else except themselves. Yes, that's it. The way you love me, they don't like. Why? She has nothing to do with you. She has no blood tie, nothing. Who is the Supreme Master Qinghai anyhow? Huh? Why you just listen to her and don't listen to me? Doesn't matter if she say the right thing or I say the wrong thing. As long as you listen to her, it's wrong. You must listen to me. Thing like that, you know? The family member would dictate. Why? You always listened to me before. Now you change. You can't. You have to listen to me all the time, even if I know I'm wrong. That's the human nature. And then they go out and sell me, you know, to the newspapers or whatever. So the newspapers are not always guilty. They listen to all kind of gossip and then they print it out what they don't know. Understand? So for me, I live through all this. No problem. Just by the way, I tell you all this, so you have to think more, huh, of what you want to do. It's not as easy as we think. Things are not so simple. It might be simple and pure at this moment only, or for a few days, few weeks, but it developed different. So any one of you want to follow, want to go with me, please think about it. Don't bother, don't rush, and It's okay where you are. I told you already, you have to make a village where you live. And if you cannot attract anybody else, and then make a village of yourself alone. Why? You are the chief, you are the village inhabitants, anything, you control your world. Right? It's also a village. You are with the master, you are with God. Three of us. It's crowded enough for a village. All right, brother, anything else? You finished? Okay. Continue to do it. You're an engineer, huh? Have build a center, it's good for people. Yeah?
Yes, cool. Con có cái thói quen xấu, nhiều khi con muốn đổi để cho gia đình con đi theo sư phụ, nhưng mà con đổi được có một ngày hai ngày cái thói quen xấu nó trở lại tiếp nữa.
Thói gì
vậy? Dạ, ví dụ nhiều khi ba mẹ con nói gì sư phụ, con có thích, con không thích, con thích nghe nói, con chạy vô phòng con thiền, nói gì vậy đó, cái nhiều khi cái chuyện nó qua rồi cái nó trở lại nữa. Rồi nó cứ vậy miết luôn à.
Thế là ba má không thích sư phụ hả?
Dạ.
Thôi đừng có trả lời làm chi. Nói mà họ không hiểu thì thôi. Hãy đưa sách ra cho họ coi. Nếu không coi thì thôi.
Dạ.
Tự mình bảo vệ lấy mình.
Dạ.
Rất là lúc nào cũng phải nhẹ nhàng, hiếu thuận.
Dạ.
Mấy ba má thấy con trai tôi nó biến thành tốt mà.
Dạ.
Thế vậy họ mới cảm động chứ. Phải thương yêu ba má nhiều hơn lúc trước mới được chứ.
Dạ.
Tại vì họ không biết mà. Yeah. Mình là người đã biết rồi, mình may mắn phải không?
Yeah.
Còn ba má dù là ba má của mình nhưng mà vẫn còn trong vòng vô minh, mình phải thương xót họ thêm.
Yeah.
Phải tìm hết cách để thương yêu. Hồi trước ba má hỏi cái biểu làm gì không chịu làm, bây giờ làm liền.
Yeah.
Trước khi ba má hỏi đã làm liền rồi.
Yeah.
Tối ngày phải săn sóc coi ba má có cần cái gì không, có cần con giúp cái gì không.
Yeah.
Mình phải quan sát coi ba má mình thích cái gì.
Yeah.
Ví dụ ba má từ tối thích đấm bóp này, bữa nay mẹ mệt không con đấm bóp, ví dụ vậy đó. Chứ ba mừng mà thấy con mình tiến bộ, phải không?
Yeah.
Tại sao ba má mà nói sư phụ con tốt là bởi vì ba má không có hiểu sư phụ. Tưởng
yeah.
là sư phụ dụ dỗ con cái của mình để nó làm chuyện tầm bậy tầm bạ.
Yeah.
Nếu mà em càng ngày càng tốt, càng hiếu thảo á,
yeah.
thì ba má biết là cái bà này bà dạy tốt, mình phải
yeah.
tự giúp chứ hả? Ở nhà không phải lúc nào cũng lo ăn hoặc là bỏ đi ngồi thiền, phải kiếm chuyện làm cho ba má yeah. vui lòng, hiểu không?
Yeah.
Thấy ba má thấy siêng năng này đó, nó giúp đỡ ba má, tại vì người lớn họ có rất nhiều cái phiền não, em có biết
yeah.
không? Làm cha mẹ không có dễ, đi qua cái sức nhất là làm việc ở trong cái thế giới này để
yeah.
mà nuôi nấng con cái không phải là một chuyện dễ. Mình phải hiểu cái tâm sự của ba má nữa.
Yeah.
Rồi cái lớn lên nó sợ nó đi lạc tầm bậy tầm bạ, sợ người ta dụ dỗ, nó còn nhỏ nó không biết nữa.
Yeah.
Nó đủ thứ lo lắng, cái áp lực nó lớn lắm. Em phải hiểu như vậy, phải không?
Yeah.
Phải lo giúp đỡ ba má, phải tìm hiểu ba má muốn cái gì rồi làm cho ba má vui lòng.
Yeah.
Chứ đừng có bao giờ mà ngồi đó mà chờ ba má làm cho mình vui lòng. Mình phải làm cho ba má vui lòng
yeah.
trước, tại mình là con cái.
Yeah.
Phải không cưng? Cái này kiếm chuyện làm. Kiếm chuyện làm, lau nhà, lau cửa sạch sẽ, nhà cửa lau sạch sẽ, thấy ba má làm cái gì thì chạy theo giúp,
yeah.
phải không? Hoặc là làm trước khi ba má hỏi,
yeah.
ba má đi về thì có cơm nước thì dọn ra, hâm nóng nóng rồi, con hâm nóng rồi cho ba má ăn, chứ săn sóc một chút, niềm nở, chứ đừng có lúc nào cũng nghĩ, sao ba má tôi dở quá, tôi đi theo ông thầy hay quá, mà cứ chửi thầy tôi hoài, không cần biết,
yeah.
không cần biết, mình làm bổn phận của mình thương yêu thôi. Còn cái bổn phận của ba má, cái vấn đề họ suy nghĩ đó là quyền của họ.
Dạ.
Không ngờ sư họ chửi sư phụ đâu, chửi người đâu mà nổi nóng.
Hả? Con vô phòng thiền.
Thiền cũng không được, cái lúc đó thiền gì nổi. Đầu óc cái vẫn nổi khói lên, xong ngồi thiền, dẹp đi cho rồi, làm bộ. Phía sau.
thưa sư phụ, con có một chuyện rất là lạ. Khi hồi con còn nhỏ, mỗi buổi sáng con thức dậy thì con thấy
thấy sao?
Con thấy một giống như ngôi sao nhỏ nhỏ, rất là nhiều bay xung quanh cái khuôn mặt của con. Mà rất là nhiều bay.
Hiểu.
Bay chỉ có lúc đó thì chỉ bay rất là khoảng chừng một phút thôi. Nhưng mà lâu lâu con mới thấy một lần. Từ khi mà con được thọ trong ấn rồi thì con thấy hoài luôn. Con mà được thấy lâu thêm nữa, như là cũng được 2-3 phút lần. Và ánh sáng rất là đẹp mà nó bay vòng vòng trước mặt con rất là nhiều. Con không hiểu cái đó là cái gì.
Cái đó là tại hồi trước mình còn tu hành rồi, mình còn nhỏ, cái tâm hồn của mình còn trong sạch rồi mình mới nhớ lại. càng lớn nó nhiều, thường thường nhỏ thì mình hay thấy như vậy, thường thường những người lớn là mất rồi, nhưng mà em mà không mất được thì tốt chứ sao đâu. À, ok. Này, cũng như sự tu hành vậy đó thôi. À, đừng có chấp nhất vào đó, hiểu chưa? Đừng có chấp nhất cái cảnh giới đó, nghĩ là bây giờ sư phụ nói tốt quá rồi, không có ngày cứ ngồi đó con ngồi sầu hoài. Có nhiều cảnh giới tốt hơn. Này, thấy đó thì để thấy, không thấy thì không thấy, đừng có không cần không có biết. Ok. Yeah. Ok. Yes, anything else? Okay, okay.
I just want to tell you that how much changed in my life after, not even before initiation.
Yes.
Even before initiation, I confronted a lot of obstacle, but finally, your power is overpower everything else. So.
Meanwhile, you prepare for initiation.
I already initiated.
Yes. I don't mean while you prepare, you already have blessing from God.
Oh, wonderful.
Good, good.
I couldn't thank you enough for all
so that. Thanks, God.
That's a miracle happening almost every day.
Good, good.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. I told you, yes. I told you God can make everything happen, yes. Okay. But we must have the purity in our heart to accept it. We must have the power of faith to make it come true. Whether we can reject it, you know, by our own negative expectation about God. Already everything is there. God make everything already, but we don't know where to get it. If we are blind, if we don't have enough faith, then it don't come. It don't materialize. That's all. Okay, that group.
我是与今年七月份来自中国大陆的东北，我们来到就是这个修行的天堂，就是为了修行观音法门。就是我的同修们，他们在那样艰苦的环境里修行的非常精进，经常倒禅，经常在一起共修，经常在一起探讨师父的教理。但是就尽管这样，越是艰苦，越是爱师父，道心越坚强。 不愿意给师父造成任何的麻烦，愿意跟师父在一起，为加持这个世界的和平，精进的修行，非常爱师父。
我懂了，谢谢你们，谢谢大家，
我们来到异国他乡来修行，就是得到师父的极大的加持和无比的关爱。所以说，虽然困难重重，但是我们生活学习的非常充实。 我们每遇到问题，都师父都在所谓的梦中给我们指示。但是说有一个问题就是说，给我们用图像指示，那么我们一个人分析不出来，悟不出来，我们两个人在一起就是互相探讨。所以这样的话呢，有的时候一段时间就师父就没有图像了。当过一段以后呢，遇到关键的时候呢，师父还是用图像来指示我们。我不知道，就是说。
我们母女在一起探讨这个师父的这个指示，算不算那个就是谈体验？应该如何？也算。不过如果不懂了，可以谈，没关系。好吗？
好，谢谢师父。
不是为了夸张什么，没关系。真的不懂的话才问。如果以后有发生一样的情况，尽量自己先参考。如果真的不懂才讨论。OK。
好，谢谢师父。谢谢师父。我有两个问题，我是从北京来的，那北京的大陆同修呢，就是也是请，让我跟师父问个好。他们呢没有写信，他们说如果有什么问题呢，都愿意在打坐中和多看师父的书，来自己学习。他们因为怕麻烦师父，不加师父的负担。
我告诉你们一个秘方。 不用写信，送给我也可以。不过可以写下来，把它写下来以后，答案就到了。OK，
谢谢师父。不一定是这样。谢谢师父，我还有一个问题。就是我自己，就是修行以后，我经常有一些就是做梦的时候，因为师父讲做梦也是体验，但是我做梦的时候经常犯戒，我就不知道像这种情况，
犯戒的体验，
我觉得很。 很惭愧，也觉得很内疚，但是我就不知道怎么能够解决。有时候甚至就是我打完坐，那睡着了，也会这样，我就觉得很难受。
Okay, 不用不用难受，没关系，做梦就是做梦嘛，啊，难受什么？有时候我们那个欲望里面呢、啊，没办法解决，在那个外在的时候，我们是喜欢自己检讨嘛，自己整理自己，所以没有犯戒，就这个欲望还没办法完全洗掉，所以在梦中的时候，它只要显露一点出来，那在梦中总比外面好，没关系，没有人受害，啊？
谢谢师傅。
哎，不客气。不要自责自己那么多了，我们尽量做就好了，不能啊，我们在这种情况很难修行啊，到处都是诱惑了啊，能够这样子已经很好了啊。嗯，还有像大陆的同修，既然情况那么困难，不过能够修行，就说你们很有本事啊，啊，比我好呢，我不知道如果我在这种情况还能不能坚信修行呢？啊，所以恭喜大家，这个是这种情况，让你们更坚强、更好、更有那个智慧啊！因为你们的渴望性很高强，所以那个你们得到的东西又更多，上帝会弥补的，上帝会弥补的。看不到外在师父，一定看到里面的师父，一定体验满满。啊，我说每天都有人，都有师父照顾啊。我说不要怕，已经很好了，已经很好。任何的时间都有这种问题，不是说现在，也不是说大陆而已，自古以来修行的人要出三界的难关，一定会有那个障碍，所以我们自己能克服才好。啊，你们大陆的人很让师父感动。还有很受上帝的那个喜爱啊，你们不要退心，不要怕。 OK，
师父你好，我有个问题，我看录影带的时候，为什么师父变成那个男的修行人？
谁？
师傅在荧幕上呀。
啊，在电视上啊，你眼镜花掉了。
对呀、啊，是幻觉啊，还是？
那别人也看到这样吗？
没有，因为
只有你一个人、啊。
自己一个人在家里看。
我告诉过啊，我是不男不女，你还不相信？
啊 ，OK，
没有问题嘛，啊，真人是没男相没女相的、啊，就是让你们偶尔知道师傅真的不是女孩子，所以别看不起我。这种体验嘛，我们专心的时候就体验会出来，并非说应该坐在那里眼睛闭起来才看到真相的东西。这个真相啊，跟我们所每天看到不一样，我们看到的情况，我们看到人并非他这个样子，我们经过眼睛，经过我们那个成见，经过我们头脑过滤的时候，看到东西不大真的。我们用灵魂看，我们集中的时候，我们就变成我们自己本人，那个灵魂自己看，哎，那个时候才是看到真相啊，就这样子而已啊。啊，
我一直很仔细在眨眨眼睛在看，一直看，
还是一样，
还是男的。
对呀、啊，我告诉过你了，有什么新鲜的事？
Okay.
我就是大丈夫嘛。我们用眼睛看都看错了，所以这个世界佛才说是幻想的世界，做梦的，大梦的啊。我们生活就是一个大梦，因为我们看习惯了，认为是真的，真正的是不一样啊。所以就说、哎，就是女生不能成佛，就这样子、啊。因为本来没有男没有女，如果你固执认为你是女，当然你不能成佛。啊，了解没有 ？OK。所以我身体做什么，你们别管。我行动怎么样，别管，因为不像你看那个样子。我对待谁什么样，不是像你看那个样子。 我骂谁也不是骂他，我处理他的情况。啊，如果不懂的话就多打坐，别批评，别判断那么久那么急，然后等一下后悔退掉自己的果位，然后又重新再来，很麻烦。 OK， 就这样子，这个体验是要让你这样知道而已。 OK， 要让你了解情况不是像我们所想所看，这样就好了。 OK， yeah， next one.
I'd like to thank you for being a selfless teacher by example, and I'd like to know how we can learn more unconditional love, humility and compassion.
We learn by practice. Okay, we learn by practice. If you see somebody needs your help, needs your love, you try to express your highest love, yeah, highest helpfulness to them. And by doing it all the time, it becomes nature. And once it becomes your second nature, it will never go away. And that's how you acquire it. Not really acquire it, you reclaim it. You always have it. It's just you have to express it. Like to say, oh, I love you, but what would you do for it, you know? Like yesterday I told you how to take care of your husband and wife. Even in a, you call it a loveless relationship, you have to work at it. After a while, your love will become his love as well, and then mingle together, and your loving relationship is reborn again. For example, we women always expect that the men run after us. Why don't you run after the men? Yeah. Try a new style. Imprint your own lifestyle. Yeah. Instead of waiting for the man to buy you a rose or the husband to buy you a rose, why don't you buy him one? I always buy flowers for my husband when we were together. He bought me flowers too, but I don't always wait. Huh? You just be the one that you wish him to be, or her to be, or whoever that is with you to be. Then that person can learn too. Maybe he's shy, or maybe the person you contact with is shy and don't know how to express. You have to be bold and make the move. Show the word, teach them, lead them, let them more freely express their own feeling through your own action. Just say, I love you, and don't do nothing about it. Okay, if you love your husband, hug him when he comes home. Hug him whenever you can, for no reason. Give him a present, or give your wife a present, even not on birthday. Anything, every day, renew your love, show your feeling. Not to say, oh, I love you. You know that already, don't you, honey? You know. She might know, but she might not know. He might know, he might not know. Men, women are always insecure. There are always a lot of men and women out there. Why me? Why he loves me? How can he? I'm so ugly. I'm so imperfect. How can he love me? But he does. Yeah? But we cannot help to feel insecure sometimes. Yeah? So renew your love. Express it all the time. And then it becomes unconditional. Because the other person knows, oh, I'm not perfect, you know, I know I'm not perfect, I have this mistake, that mistake, but she still loves me, and that is unconditional. Okay? Practice it. Huh? Don't just talk. Do something. Okay? Do something all the time. There's another kind of practice, easy. You walk on the street all the time. You see somebody need help, just help him and then leave. Huh? Or you see a homeless person on the street standing there, hungry, just hand him some bill. And live. And walk a woman across the street. Take her across the traffic light, slowly, lovingly, like a daughter. And live. Do anything like that all the time. Or your neighbor have trouble, just write a letter, a loving letter, and pop in the letterbox and leave. Sign your neighbor if you want. If you don't, don't have to also. Or just to do something unexpectedly, you know. Anything sometimes, you have to look out for the opportunity, yeah, to serve and to practice unconditional love. Or normally you scold your daughter and son all the time, you know. Now instead you reflect and sit down and see what their needs are and surprise them with some loving gesture, some loving present, something that they ask so long. and is harmless, is good for them, and you can afford it, but you refuse them because you don't want them to have. Maybe buy them for them, things like that. Not wait for Christmas. Well, at least Jesus was born so that you give each other something each year. Any day you can do it. Or make an excuse even, or your birthday, instead of asking people to buy presents for you, buy presents for the poor people that you know. Huh? Christmas, instead of waiting to get presents, buy presents to people that you know, on the street even, the people you don't know also. If you go and seek out the homeless, give them presents. That's the best Christmas. Or Qinghai Day, if you say you love me so much, buy presents for people. For the loved one, for the initiate that you love, for your husband, for your wife. Don't spend too much money, don't have to. Just something, appreciation. Or if somebody really in need of something and you know he needs it and you can afford it, then help him anonymously. You know, something like that. Very easy to practice unconditional love all the time. Because it's natural, it's a natural thing to do. Oh, I couldn't think of many other examples. I don't know, you will have to know. It's a natural thing. Yeah, it's a good practice. Yeah? For example, Qinghai Day, you know, we don't always have to celebrate in grand scale. Yeah? And we celebrate privately as can be, you know, us all together with it, apart from it. You can buy presents and give it to the poor people. Yeah? Or give them money, or take medicine, give it to the one who really needs. Really needs. And that is unconditional love. Huh? Okay? That should be a very, very good thing to do. Hmm? That's why people buy gifts on Christmas. To celebrate the love that Christ has imparted to us. To celebrate the unconditional way He sacrificed for mankind. Yeah? So we can do that in any occasion to remind us of the loving kindness within ourselves. Hmm? Okay. So, or hug your colleagues, yeah? Or tell her she's good, she's okay, because sometimes she has inferior complex, she has a problem of her own. Or forgive the one that always hate you and pick on you. Buy her a present, compliment on her dress. Make her feel happy as a human being. They can hate you, they can make trouble for you, but you always have to be kind and loving. That way is hatred. Yeah, and revenge. Your way is kindness and loving. We have to choose our own way, despite the situation. The same with, I told you about a journalist or something, if they want to come, or if they want to interview, treat them kindly, give them the information they need. And whatever they write is their problem. We have to do our best. Always treat everyone with kindness and compliments, yeah, and sincerity. Yeah? Don't push them out. If they want to know you, it's fine, let them know. But just tell them that we are spiritual practitioners. We are not good at formulating, you know, headlines. We probably don't know how to speak. So ask them, they try their best to make the best out of whatever they can. Yeah, but we are not a professional preacher. Not a professional lecturer. So sometimes when we talk, we tumble here and there. That's why we are afraid of interview, waste the time, and perhaps don't know how to bring the information to the best of their use. Just want them like that, okay? Don't push them away. Have to treat them kindly, because they also have to do their job. They have to earn their living. They are just as struggling as you are for survival in this world. It happens that they have to be journalists by choice or by situation. We help them, yeah, to gain more knowledge, to gain better understanding about us, instead of blaming them or disliking them for what they have written. You know, they have just wrong information, so you supply a right one. And after all your best effort and try to supply everything, they still write bad things, which happened many times to me. It's okay too. Forgive them. Yeah? And that's unconditional love too. See? All the time. All the time. Opportunity everywhere. Okay, next. You're welcome. Yes.
师父好，我是从悉尼小中心来的。我来之前碰到一个大陆的师姐，她是从新疆来的。她说我没有机会去看师父，我们在新疆也修得很精进，
是，
所以她说希望我来的时候向师父问好，转达他们的问候。
哦，是，谢谢。
然后还有一个悉尼的大陆同修，他因为他护照的问题他来不了，但是呢他也为了这次我能来，他也尽了很大的心和帮助。我看出他对师父那种诚心，我也带他向师父问好。
OK。
还有我自己有一个问题，我自己有个问题，就是我一个人打坐的时候比较容易静下来，但是我一参加共修的时候，就总觉得好像比较难静下来，不知道为什么。请师父开始。
大概你看太多别人吧。注意太多，啊！发生什么事？啊，那个男孩子好看，那个女孩子好丑。别管别人 ，OK 哈。
师父，今年三月一星的时候，不久师父就离开台湾了。我那时候很担心见不到师父了，现在我很高兴在这里，我觉得好像在做梦一样。
这么厉害啊！
对，我想告诉师父说，台湾的同修比以前更爱师父。
我知道。如果下一个。
师父你好，那个我和我太太一起来参加这个禅舞是非常幸运的，因为我太太已经怀孕八个多月了，而且她还是在同学的鼓励下来参加这个禅舞期。那个我们很幸运，我们是在吃素以后，那个学了方便法以后，我太太怀的孕。所以说很多同学都说我们是怀的 little Buddha， 所以说这是师父给我们的那个福报。那个我就是有点小的那个请求，因为他们台湾的同修都说以前他们好多这个师姐师兄有那个同修的有孩子，说师父可以给名字，我就不知道师父能不能给我们这个小 Buddha 一个起个名字。
他是女的是男的？
男的，是个男的。是个男的。
好，那我们叫他金光，啊，
金光，
啊，
谢谢师父。
金白的金，
金光
亮的光。
谢谢师父，这是我太太。
好了，耶，
师父你好。
不不，你们何必执着名字嘛，自己选更好。
我们主要希望师父给我们那个名字，这个对未来的那个那个辅导一个保护，让他更好的成长以后。
名字是上阵而已，上帝保护他。
谢谢。
他来这边自己也保护自己。
谢谢师父。
这个名字不算嘛，你们生自己的小孩是很敬爱的，所以平常都会喜欢自己一个名字给他，就觉得是我的。我不用我取名字啊，有时候有机会这样就取一取，没有也没关系，自己想一个很漂亮的名字，很有修行的那个意思送给他啊，也是师父送的，也是上帝送的，任何都是上帝送的，何必就给人送呢？给人送。Next one.
Master, before initiation, I used to go to temple with my parents.
Yes.
And I tried to learn the chant the sutra.
Yes.
And but ever since I got initiated, I didn't go anymore and.
Why don't you go to the temple with them?
Because I don't have time. I'm a student.
Oh,
so,
I see.
So
don't
I
you
didn't
tell
go.
Them?
But my mom was not happy, so I'm not sure what to do.
Okay. Promise her after study or on semester or occasion, you know, you will accompany her to the temple. Or ask her to go to the temple with you whenever you have time.Ask her, you know, make the initiative. Let her know that you still like to go to temple with her. It's just that sometimes you don't have time.
So
and show it, okay?
Okay, so it's okay to, bow to the...
Of course it's okay.
Okay.
Of course it's okay, as long as you know it's not the real Buddha. The Buddha is inside you, it's all right.
Thank you.
Understand? No problem. Hey, you know, it's always it's also very sweet to go to the temple or to go to the church, to be ordinary person. It's very romantic to go to the church on Sunday or go to the temple on Sunday. Just be whatever you like and do whatever you can. Everywhere is Buddha's land, let alone the temple. And sometimes go to the temple, huh? And sit there and bow to the Buddha with an incense. Romantic. Yeah? You have to make the best out of every situation and put a touch of poetry into it. And everything is fine. What I mean that you should not bow to idol and that you should not even deliberately do it, you understand? Because that means you are very low level still. You don't understand the real Buddha. And that's all. But if you understand, you can bow to thousands of statues. There's no harm. Okay? Next.
亲爱的师父, 如果我说我现在已经, 感觉是在天堂上的话, 请师父不要笑我, 因为我是住在美国冰天雪地, 鸟不生蛋的地方, 所以我好几次下来, 洛杉矶, 想等师父, 没有等到, 所以我每次都请很多师父的法相, 家里挂了九大章, 我每到个地方都看到师父, 而且我感觉到师父的慈悲大爱力, 浩然之气, 真善美智的完美形象, 真的真的, 我在家里,
just feel so good. 都是你自己本人的真善美的。不，我是师父给我们一种完美的典范。你这怎么样的话，你就会感觉别人怎么样。谢谢您，我们全家人觉得师父非常非常的美。
我每次经过师父的法相，跟师父说话，眨眨眼，好像您都看到我，而且我都好希望说，师父，我像有一天能用电子像您那么漂亮。这是我的女孩子的想法。今天呢，真的是感谢师父能够亲临洛杉矶，我有这个机会见到您本人，我都以为可能又看不到了，而且更是惊喜的，那我们心灵心的人那么靠近您，能够看到您，所以我说真的好像是真的是置身在天堂上。
因为没有共修的关系，请师父指引我，是不是我参加这种禅期能够弥补这个没有共修的这种进步？可以，可以，当然。我们有时候每天没办法那个打坐那么静静，因为事情太忙碌了，所以才偶尔合起来共修。那个时候真正全部都放下啊。 没事情要做，这就比较专心，进步比较快，就可以心想里面的境界比较长久。就这样，在家坐一坐就要工作了，坐一坐就小孩来吵，坐一坐就电话，坐一坐就现身要这个要那个等等。所以我们在这边呢，能够来这边就什么都不管的了。
感谢师父。
所以比较好，对自己好一点，当然会好啊。以后。 像那些没办法去共修，因为住太远的话，也可以来参加禅期，不算是不去共修是不能去的。那有时候情况不一样，所以如果那些不能共修的人，也要跟联络人员跟他们讲，拜托一下。如果觉得自己太愧疚的话，就坐后面一点，不吵别人，听懂哈？
我懂，谢谢。
好，不客气。
我是一年多以前知道 Master 的，感谢师父照顾，其中我还是一心的，就是说，我现在有一个问题就是这样子，好像师父讲24小时应该把注意力集中在 Wisdom Eye 那地方，然后，但是我感觉观音的时候，尤其好像集中不起来，集中不到那个地方去，观音的时候，
也是集中那里，但是我感觉好像集中不起来，然后有时候观音完了以后，感觉好像。
好像在做，好像梦境一样。懂。那你就进入另外一个境界，那就让他这样子吧。就这样子。
集中为了要进入那个高一点的境界。如果你已经开始觉得很舒服、很愉快，那个表示说已经进入状况了。
OK。
进入那个三摩地了。
Oh, really? Thank you, Master.
OK， 我们集中为了进入那里，在那边都不能再集中了。 管他了，你一集中就跑，再跑回来。OK，next
one。师傅，我是从大陆东北来的。我来的时候，家乡同学们也是千叮咛万嘱咐，让我向师傅代他们问好。另外，他们还有一个最大的心愿，就是希望能早日看到肉身师傅。他们在家乡望着。 而且呢希望能够即使看不到肉身师父，能够早日在街上在公园里能看到化身师父就好。我自己还有一个问题哈，我有的时候我接触到师父的教理之后吧，我觉得师父说的走中庸之道我觉得也很好，我接受的也很快，但是这个头脑很难控制，有的时候一想到师父承担了我们生生世世的业障，就有一种罪恶感，觉得对不起师父。
为什么？
哎呀，每天就背着很沉重的十字架似的，觉得很对不起师父。
别这么，我们难过好不好、啊、
好，谢谢师父。我现在滨州小中心共修，每个星期我都去、
okay.
有的时候呢当师兄师姐们知道我是从大陆引新的，也都很羡慕，说你很不容易啊。我说是啊，我说在大陆听到师父的名字都是福报，我是因为一个搬家的机缘，否则我这辈子遇不上师父。
嗯 ，OK。
因为一个搬家的机缘，我碰见了一个有缘人。
嗯，
我接触到师父的教理就被粘住了。
哎呀，啊、好厉害！
哎，所以我感谢师父。
我是感谢，
我特别感谢师父。
Okay. 不要太自责哈，没什么对不起我的。
嗯。
我是很荣幸做这份工作、
嗯、
不过我也不能告诉你们是最好的一份工作而已啊，我抱怨不过还是继续做啊，我不能说是最好的，最喜欢的，最合意的，不过反正没有别的工作更好的啊，所以我就暂时接受 OK 啊。
所以
我
帮了师父、
啊、
我就想到我能在大陆认心里，我直接就跑出来
啊，
我一想到师父替我担了业障，我这么有福气，我有这么一位好师父，生生世世都难遇的师父，我的自卑感又出来了，所以我就觉得这个头脑很难控制，
是、啊、
怎么样能够走中庸之道？
不理他，
不理他。好，谢谢师父。
Next,
everything that I've read says that we are entering a millennium of harmony and peace and prosperity.
Oh yes.
Even Native Americans with the white buffalo.
Uh huh.
I hear the pain from the people here. I think, can we give them a word of encouragement of the good things to come? Even in fact, what happened in Taiwan, we can use this as a problem and an opportunity.
Opportunity for what?
For growth.
Oh, so every opportunity is an opportunity for growth. Every millennium is a golden millennium. It depends on what we feel inside and how we see the world outside.See, when we develop wisdom eye, we see things differently. Every age is a golden age. Ah, and if it's not, we're not developed spiritually, every age is dark age. Ah, no problem. For us, the golden millennium is already there.
师父，如果说我没有共修的话，是不是比较不容易一时解脱，是属于比较打坐不精进？
比较有同修就打坐都比较简单一点，
是
共修的时候打坐比较近
啊、
嗯、因为很多人坐在一起啊，那个力量比较大，大家互相鼓励。嗯，还有去共修，有时候我们自己心里有什么问题、
嗯、
或者家庭有什么困难，跟同修谈一谈就觉得舒服多了。嗯，然后自己兄弟姐妹一起吃饭就觉得有温暖的那种家庭的感情，有一点对自己那个世界的有一点那个security 感觉，就是安全感这样，哎，有兄弟姐妹这样 ，OK，
谢谢。
打坐多的话，力量比较大，就这样子，嗯，有时候比较快进步。不过看情况啦，如果你在家很静静，自己就没有乱念，也是很好，嗯，看情况嘛。因为美国这么大，我是任何地方都很大，要去共修不是每一次都那么方便，如果不方便就跟那个过滤的人讲，嗯，说我真不方便，我工作太忙，小孩太多，父母太老，地方太差太远，先生太凶，我自己太烂。
师父，你真是活菩萨。
OK, next one, please.
师父好，我就是观音的时候很不能专心，而且观音的时候整浑身的皮肤都觉得痒痒的，就
irritating, 我知道，
cannot concentrate.
我知道。 继续做都会好，哎，继续做会好。这个是因为我们里面有一些不干净的成分，不管是意念也好，不管是身体不健康也好，它就出来了。它出来才养，那种毒啊，
嗯，
毒液出来才养。那你买一些擦痒的药擦一擦，或是洗澡，嗯，以后就会好。它一出来就会好了，啊，不管它，出来比在里面好啊。
是
啊，这是毒的东西啊。OK。All right.
Hi, I have two children. They are 7 and 10 years old.And I know that they can get initiation, but I don't know what initiation would mean to them. And how can I help them? So if they, can they share experiences?
You can meditate with them. Children don't have to meditate a lot, but they have to keep the same precepts like you do. Okay? And it's also up to them if they like it or not. Whether they already know me from the teaching and they like to follow your footsteps. Huh?I see. Okay. They are vegetarian too?
Almost.
Almost. Okay. Wait until they are all vegetarian, then decide. Okay. And when you are vegetarian, make sure you have enough nutrition, huh? You eat tofu, gluten, and all kind of vegetable protein, huh? Don't just eat the vegetable, and you become like one. Mm. And then your children must have enough nutrition.So the people don't blame you for, you know, being a bad example, okay? Make sure, take care that all the things you cook and eat are nutritious. We have some simple cookbooks. This is also enough. We add in with some fruit and nuts and other things, you know, together with this, this will be fine. Make sure, huh? Okay? You're healthy? You feel good?Good, with vegetarian, okay. And there's no reason why your children cannot be initiated and follow your footsteps. No? Just meditate together like you do with all the tongsu. And whatever question they ask you, they will not have to even ask question. They will have their inner answer like you. Hmm? But if they ask you, you try your best to answer, no problem. Like friend, you know, meditate together, it's cute. Okay, next one.
Hi, Master. I was initiated December 14th.
Yeah.
And after like a couple of weeks later, I practiced like very hard. I meditated the whole day. But then when I go to sleep, I can see the light and it's like traveling very fast.
Mm-hmm.
But I try to take a look around, but...It's like everywhere is white light, so I was afraid.
Everywhere what?
I mean, it's all white.
White light. Uh-huh. White light. Uh-huh. Why you should be afraid of the light? You should be afraid of darkness.
But there should be something like an object I can
see. A scenery or thing like that.
Right.
You are the object.
I'm the object.
Huh? Originally, there is no object anyhow. You just go back to the...almost original situation.
Oh.
No problem, don't be afraid. Why, you're a big man.
Okay, so then I try to open my eyes, but then it's like very hard to open it, because like...
Oh yes, at that time the eyes is not under your control, because you left your physical body, okay?
Oh, okay. So then I wasn't able to control my body, so...
After a while, you'll be able to...regain the complete control of the body, okay?
Okay. All right, thank you.
Mm. Sometimes your soul, you know, don't completely live, eh? So partially you are under control, sometimes not. Don't worry about that. You just enjoy, okay? Enjoy. Enjoy whatever situation you are in, eh? In that kind of samadhi. It's good for you. Don't worry. Next one.
I would like to thank you very much about your help of my country, Cambodia.
You're welcome.
About 2 years initiated, I couldn't find my people. But this five-day retreat helped me a lot, that I can find my people. That's why I thank you for 5-day retreat to help me a lot.
Yes, it's good.
Yeah.
That's why we have retreats. Huh? Five friends and comforters, and companions.
Yeah. My question about Cambodia, most 90%, 95% is Buddhist. Mm-hmm. But they eat meat.
Yeah.
But my question, they have two types of Buddhism. One is Mahayana, mm-hmm. and the other one is Hinayana. May I ask you about which type you don't eat meat?
Mahayana.
That's why I would like to, when somebody asks me, I can answer
yes.
about it.
The Buddha originally never allowed people to eat meat, but some of the people like convenient method, you know. We also here have also convenient method people who also can eat meat, and they also claim to be my follower. But because they are weak, and they just want to practice the halfway like convenient method for their own liberation. So it's okay. You know, I give them convenient method. They are also our brothers and sisters. They can come and meditate sometime in their own time. That is the so-called Hinayana in Buddhism. And Mahayana is the one who has a bigger heart, who forsake all the pleasure like meat eating, yeah, in order to reach the higher level of consciousness, in order to be able to help himself and his family, his many generations, and the fellow beings also. Now, the Hinayana or those practice Guanyin method by us can only liberate himself or herself alone. He can eat a little bit meat, no problem. Because the Buddha also say that there are some kind of meat, okay, if in case of emergency or you don't know where to find food, you can eat. The Buddha said very clearly in the Suragama Sutra and I think Nirvana Sutra too, that you, if you cannot find anything else, that you have to survive. Then you eat the meat that you don't kill yourself, that you know that people don't kill because of you, that you don't hear the animal cry while killing for you, etc. Although other animal has been eaten half by other animals, or the animal die naturally, or sick die, then you can eat them. Refrain from killing the animal yourself for meat. You see what I mean? So the Cambodian monk follow this tradition. Because I think originally, if any monk come to Cambodia to spread Buddhism, nobody have any vegetarian for him. So he had to just do whatever it is and refrain from killing the animal himself. And after a while, it become like a tradition. Because it's not in India, it's not easy for people to find vegetarian at that time. So it become a Hinayana tradition in Cambodia. Okay?
Thank you, Master.
Yes, you're very welcome. Time. Let's go home, eat. Thank you. That's okay, no. Stay down, stay down. I go first, okay? Right.
See you soon. See you later.
Okay, thank you for inviting me here.
再见，我们等一下回台湾的。啊，
一路顺风啦。 新年快乐, 啊? 都看到了没有啊?
看不到师父看电视也好, 看电视给看到的眼睛, 你刚才没听到一个人, 他看师父电视也变来变去吗? 啊, 他也是很华丽的, 有那种华丽的那种勾结嘛, 那种华丽勾结, 再次就还是一样, 啊, 胶片什么都会有一点影响, 啊? 看电视也好, okay.
Never enough, but never mind. Can come closer, have a look. Yeah.
I don't know why you have to look at me. I cannot understand. I really cannot.
Okay. Yes. Honey pie.
Okay, I see you later. Thank you too. Thanks to you. Oh, these are new people, right? Okay, wait. Okay, be strong, walk in love, walk in love and beauty. All right? Yes. Look at my eyes, better than my hands. You take me with you in your heart, all right? That is the place, the safest place, the biggest safe box. Nobody can take it away from you. And never rotten, never die, okay? Take me with you in your heart, yeah? There. I will forever love you. Through all the world, through all the love, through all the beauty that you so adore, through all the beauty that you so adore.